What I find, what could bring, you know, misconception about conflict places is, first of all, you know, we tend to understand that when there is a conflict in a general area, that the people that are caught up in the conflict themselves cannot do anything. But my experience has shown that there's always a coping capacity, and there are always some certain resilience that is built in the communities, which when you are looking for solution, you should not look at a top-down approach. You should always involve the communities, because in any case, you as a person, either military or humanitarian, bring assistance, you are coming from the outside. Certainly, the short time that it took you to deploy, you may not know everything about the social dynamics, the community dynamics, so this is why you need to involve the people, and you don't have to look at them as completely helpless. They might be able to offer some very unique and indigenous solutions to what you are looking for.
I was talking about that in respect to how the military, for instance, perceive the civilian population, which sometimes they're trying to protect, and in some instances how the civilians perceive the military, who might be trying to protect them, but in all instances might be going about it in ways that could create even more conflict.
Yes. So now you are talking in the domain of civilian-military coordination during conflict. Yes. There is the tendency, if you don't put elaborate communication between the people bringing the support, that is the military, and the people on the ground, that is the communities, throughout, right from planning to deployment and even post-conflict, there has to be continuous communication between the military that are coming in to give support and the people that are on the ground. Yes, by nature of the military, generally, it is normally a conservative, very close organization. You know, sometimes resistant to change, I can say that. And there's tendency sometimes not to divulge all information. That is understandable, because honest, as a security actor, it is not everything that you have to divulge. But you might find sometimes that there's the over tendency to hide every bit of information. What I believe is that at each stage or at each occasion, a careful assessment can be done. What is it that the civilians need to know, and which will not jeopardize operational security? And then you release that information.